G'day, I'm Ruben, and this is a video to show and tell about a synth drum box that I put together to accompany my no-input mixing rig. In my past no-input mixer sets, I've sometimes used a kick drum loop that I played off of a cassette. Or created percussive doofing noises by making a really short loop pedal loop out of touching the end of a jack plug to get that bzzz sound. And that sidechain compression-esque ducking sound is quite fun to me. So when my cassette player started to get a bit flaky, I wanted to replace it with something. My original thought bubble was some kind of audio box that just output 909 kicks at a steady pulse with one knob on it for tempo and an on-off switch, I guess, which was about as much control as I ever had on the cassette player, just start, stop, and the very speed knob. Then my friend lent me a Raspberry Pi, which is a very small computer. It has its own operating system, it can run all kinds of software, you know, web browser, whatever. You can plug in a mouse, keyboard, screen, and so on. It has all this connectivity and Wi-Fi as well. But you can also set it up to boot up and run a program every time you power it on. And that might be some kind of audio thing for which you don't need a mouse, keyboard, or screen, like setting it up to behave like an audio effects pedal or a synthesizer. To have some control inputs, you can get some potentiometers and switches and connect them to these pins. And people have made all kinds of little synth boxes and things with Raspberry Pis like this. Part of my DIY ethic in this project is to take easy routes and use what I have on hand, which is this nice little MIDI controller, an Akai LPD8, which just plugs in and works fine. And the first thing I thought about running on the Pi is Pure Data. I've been using Pure Data since about 2009. It's a patching paradigm software. Sometimes people call it visual programming. If you know of MaximSP, Pure Data is like a free open source version of that. Each of these rectangular boxes is an object that does something to data or an audio signal. Messages or audio flows through the patch cables, and you can build up quite complex structures and programs for doing things with audio. You can also build your own reusable objects called abstractions and even give them little graphic user interfaces. I've used Pure Data for all kinds of projects and collaborations and live music over the years. But the first things I did with it were chopping up guitar sounds on two albums of mine. I was using it to make kind of my own glitchy versions of loop pedals and patches that would detect a strum of my guitar and then semi-randomly cut it up. So Pure Data gave me the ability to play that material live, much more than Ableton was able to at the time. And this is before, you know, Max for Live integration and so on. And the kids say... It's pretty emo, but the influences are like Oval and Finesse, I guess. So back to my kick drum quest, I made a pure data patch to synthesize a kick drum. I drew on a few Sound on Sound magazine articles from the early 2000s to get ideas on how to go about it. They were really interesting and useful, so link in the description on those. Now let's do a breakdown of my drum synthesis in pure data. The core of my kick sound is a sine wave oscillator. Set that to 45 Hz, sounds like this. Then the volume envelope is very basic. Instead of an ADSR envelope, it's basically just AR. It's got almost instant attack and then a linear release. And that's like the simplest kick you can get, I guess, but it's all sub. You probably won't be hearing that properly on small speakers. So to get what some call the knock of the kick sound, I made that sine wave's pitch rapidly descend about an octave over the first 30 milliseconds. That pitch dive apparently emulates something that a real kick drum does due to movement of the drum skin and pressure equalizing or something like that. Here's how that sounds if the pitch dive takes a longer time and a longer drop. But here's the settings I settled on, and instantly that sounds way more kick drum-like to me. Then I added another element, which is a couple of other sine wave oscillators. They're going through this clip object that's making the waves more square. They've got the same pitch envelope being sent along this patch cable, but I'm multiplying that stream of frequency values to some higher inharmonic spots. And here's what that sounds like with a long release time. But I just want about 30 milliseconds of that as well. And that just brings a little bit of mid-frequency whack, something like a ball bouncing maybe. And then to emulate the higher frequencies of the beater smacking the drum skin, I have a noise generator here with a very quick release, just 9 milliseconds. So it's just a click sound. I spent a bit of time tweaking the pitches and mixing to taste, and this is about where I've landed. The controls that I set are for tempo, release time, pitch, level, and here's my bodgy sequencer where I can just select between a few different pre-programmed patterns. When I realized I was going to have plenty of spare knobs on my MIDI controller, I decided to patch a hi-hat as well. The first bit of the hi-hat I made is a noise oscillator with a simple volume envelope, which kind of sounds like junk. Then I put it through a bandpass filter that descends from 15 kHz to 5 kHz with a very high Q value, which gives it a somewhat pitched quality. And this was like fine, but not amazing. And next, I tried something more in line with what was suggested in the Sound on Sound article about synthesizing cymbal sounds. I used FM synthesis to make saw waves with lots of partials. And here's what they sound like. And then I added a descending pitch envelope and a simple volume envelope. And with longer release time settings, neither of these sound super convincing as an open hi-hat sound, but it's not bad as a closed hi-hat sound using the shorter release. And the patterns I have for this at the moment are your classic offbeat, and eighth notes, but an extra one on 16. and 16th notes. Now, I could much more easily just run this on my laptop, you know, but that kind of detracts from the approach that I'm taking with this particular musical project. I don't want to be looking at screens. I want to keep things hardware or hardware feeling as possible. So it's technically a little computer, but I've used it to create a thing that feels like a little drum machine toy, and I'm really enjoying basking in the limitations of that, in sort of the same way that I do with the no input mixing on my pretty small mixer.